It is good to have your company this morning. Some terrible news, breaking news coming out of New Zealand this morning. Multiple people have been killed after a fire broke out in a hostel in Wellington.
It's understood up to 90 people were staying in the building at the time of the fire. So far, 52 have been accounted for.
The city's mayor spoke to media just a short time ago.
When I got down here, we then discovered from our fire emergency team that there have been multiple fatalities, the final number yet to be determined. So it is a truly tragic situation, the worst outcome. But our fire emergency department have done a really wonderful job at managing this. They no doubt will be going through a very tough time, and of course our families of the fatalities will be going through a tough time as well.
It is a terrible scene there this morning. We're just getting more details as we go to air right now. There are some 90 people inside at the time, and only around 60 have been accounted for. So the grave concern for the others. There are also eyewitness accounts coming out of there saying that everyone living there, they have nurses, doctors, unemployed people, meat workers, hospital staff. This is an eyewitness as I'm talking to you at home. All sorts of people, a real variety of people, says one witness. The witness says it's very sad for a lot of people, not only the ones who have lost their lives, but those who've lost their homes. It's surreal. It's a terrible feeling. Lots of emergency services are on the scene right now, and still firefighters haven't been able to go into some of those club rooms, they're calling them, to try and assess just how many people were inside at the time. Remarkable stories, remarkable rescues. As we were saying before, from the roof of that hostel, clearly they couldn't go down to get out of that place. So they went to the roof, and some have been able to get out off the roof. But as you can see there, the fire just tore through this building.
At least a dozen expected to be confirmed dead, but we still don't know how many more are unaccounted for. As well, some of the emergency workers were on the phone with the occupants, and that call then cut out, so the fate of those people is still unknown. So there is still a lot to sort of work out, and this scene is just awful.
Well, there's a number of other associated issues, not just around the vicinity of the building, but it's an old building, so there are asbestos issues. So people in the Wellington area are being urged to stay away from the area, but wear masks as well. So you can see all the emergency services there have these masks on. So asbestos is another problem being loaded on to what is a significant emergency situation as we go to air this morning in Wellington. Unfortunately, it does not look good there this morning. And we'll be there live with more reports from the scene as soon as we possibly can. Tragic. Well, two people are dead and two others are in hospital this morning after a horrific crash in Melbourne. Police are right now on the scene with a major road closed as we go to air.
Today, Melbourne reporter Christina Hearn is in Caulfield South. Chris, what have police had to say so far?
Well, Sarah, police say this all happened at about 10:45 last night, so more than 7 hours on. Police remain here on scene at Caulfield South. I'll just show you around because you can see the mangled wreck of that silver Honda. Now, that is tragically where two people have died. It's some 50 metres away from that silver Honda is a black BMW. So we'll just show you that. What police say is that the male driver of that black BMW, so what you're seeing on your screen now, he was travelling along North Road when that car has collided with the silver Honda, forcing that Honda to roll. As I mentioned, the two occupants of the Honda tragically died here at the scene, while the male driver and the passenger of the BMW sustained serious injuries and were taken to hospital. Callers to 3AW here last night report that one of these cars was excessively speeding before the collision. So that's all going to form part of this investigation. The Major Collision Investigation Unit remain here on scene as they try and piece together exactly what happened. Sarah.
Thank you, Chris.
The search for a missing boat will resume in Queensland today after a yacht sank off Fraser Island. Andrea Crothers has the details in Brisbane. Andrea, woman has been rescued.
Yeah, Carl, one woman, 25 years old, rescued her friend, a man he remains unaccounted for. I've just been speaking to authorities. That air and search rescue mission will get back underway at any moment. It's been almost, or more than rather, 30 hours since the pair sent out a distress signal from their 30-foot yacht as it began to take on water at Garee Fraser Island, just north of there at Breaksea Point. Some 15 hours later, after they abandoned that yacht, that woman miraculously found, surrounded by debris, pulled to safety by the Life Flight rescue chopper. She's now recovering at Bundaberg Hospital, and hopes are that her friend can be found today and he too can do the same.
Andrea, thank you.
Now to a Today weather alert. Heavy fog has blanketed Sydney this morning. Let's head to Today correspondent Lara Vella at Sydney Airport. Lara, the Bureau has issued a warning to drivers.
Sarah, they have indeed. They've issued a road weather alert as a result of this heavy fog that descended over our western suburbs in the early hours of this morning. So as a result of it, Sarah, they're asking all drivers throughout Sydney's suburbs to be really careful when driving on the roads today. It started to descend in suburbs like Richmond and Camden at around 3 a.m. this morning, Sarah, before that thick white shroud slowly crept to our city. And as you can see from these pictures from our Skycam taken a little bit earlier, as it always does, the fog enveloped and smothered our iconic landmarks before it eventually made its way here to Sydney Airport, where we are expecting the potential for delays when it comes to flights. I've checked in with both Qantas and Jetstar this morning, Sarah. I'm still waiting for a response from them. However, I do have a statement from Air Services Australia. They've said that they've enacted extra safety measures at Sydney Airport this morning due to strong fog and patchy visibility. And as a result, there is a slight reduction in flight capacity that's expected to improve from around 8 a.m. Sydney Airport will remain on parallel runway operations for now, Sarah.
All right, Lara, thank you.
To breaking news, a gunman has shot three people before he was killed during a confrontation with police in the US state of New Mexico. Two police officers were injured during the shootout. Banks and social media platforms could be made to reimburse customers who lose money to scams. Development of a new mandatory cross-industry code will be done by the Consumer Watchdog. It comes after ASIC revealed 96% of victims of fraud and scams never get their money back. Those on Telstra postpaid mobile plans are being told to expect price increases, with the telco announcing a 7% hike. The move will allow prices to be in line with inflation, but adds another blow for Aussies struggling with the cost of living. Well, if you're looking to sign up for a membership to get the best seats at the MCG, then you'd better be prepared to wait. The Melbourne Cricket Club has revealed there are more than 200,000 people currently on its waiting list, meaning those who sign up today won't become members until 2063. What? Margot Robbie has been spotted on the Gold Coast swapping out her acting gloves for a hand at bartending. Seen pouring shots at Rosella's Bar in Burleigh Heads for some very lucky customers, the star is down under launching a new gin brand.
Good on her.
Mm.